Hi there, and welcome to the very first video tutorial from Cornflower Iris. Today I'll be sharing an adorable card and envelope to celebrate some friends moving into a new home. I'm using a stamp set free with Simply Cards and Papercraft at the moment, some Country Life patterned paper, and Kraft card for the card base. I'm cutting an A4 piece roughly in half, and scoring it at 4 and 8 inches to make a card base. I selected the paper I wanted to use and cut this out using a stitch rectangle die to add some fine detail around the panel. When making a simple card like this, small details like this really do make a huge difference. Using a honeycomb lattice from the Xcut Beekeeping die set, I created accents from ivory cardstock to add interest around the edges of the panel. This die is really nice because not only do you get the gorgeous lattice, but also a lot of small hexagons which can be used to embellish your designs. Using a glue pen, I applied adhesive where I was going to place the lattice on the card, and stuck it on. Then working with something fine like this, turning the card over and using scissors from the back really helps to achieve a clean edge. Using the principles of symmetry helps to really build a card and put it together. So by putting some at the bottom edge of the card and repeating the same process, we get a more put together look. I attached the pattern paper with some tape adhesive, then decided it would look better with some crochet trim wrapped around it. So, off camera, I carefully peeled off the panel, applied the trim, and stuck it back together with some extra adhesive. Don't be afraid to take apart your creations if you change your mind and decide to make it a bit better. I cut this really nice Verity Rose doily die from cream cardstock, and using a homemade stamp positioning tool, stamped the sentiment in Memento ink. The nice thing about using a stamp positioning tool is that you can re-stamp to achieve a crisper, darker image and align everything perfectly. If you were using an acrylic block, you might prefer to use something like archival ink, which has a deeper black. At this point, you may be able to see a smudge on the doily. This came from a baby wipe. To cover this up, I used the age-old standby of a card maker and applied some embellishments. So using a really large self-adhesive pearl, I covered that smudge up, and then using a couple of smaller pearls, created a little cluster. Then, again, applying the principles of symmetry, and I applied this to the bottom left-hand corner, just to give it a look that was slightly less random, and I was really happy with the result, quite a nice accident. To add some dimension, I used foam pads to adhere the doily to the front of the card, and then just to tie everything together, use some more adhesive pearls in the corners to add just a finishing touch. It really makes the card pop and brings everything together. That's the card front done. For the inside of the card, I didn't really have a stamp set which said what I wanted to say exactly, so I decided to hand write a sentiment using a white gel pen and a variety of fonts. This isn't well aligned, but this is a rustic card, so I didn't really mind. To make the envelope, I'm using a 1-2-3 punch board by We Are Memory Keepers and some 12x12 pattern paper from the works. You could use a store-bought envelope and dress it up to match the design, but I've really found that having this tool has opened up the possibilities for some odd-shaped cards, some impressive envelopes. Taking time on the envelope really gives the recipient a sense that this is something special and handmade that you've really spent some time on, and it's not that difficult to do. I use a complimentary red paper, cut to 8¾ inches square and added some crochet trim on another die cut doily just to make it match the card. I hand wrote the names of the lovely couple in a font to match the inside and stuck it all together with a tape runner. You can see the effect is really striking, particularly with the nice pattern on the inside. So if you can use double-sided 12x12 paper, that's even better. And again, with the tape runner, when you put things together and then decide to change the design and add some layers, you can always take it apart and stick it together. I'll leave you with some close-ups at the end of the video. Thanks very much for watching this video. If you liked it, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos in the future. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram with the handle cornfloweriris, as well as on my blog. If you have any questions, please leave me a comment below. Thanks again and see you next time.